know. But when you get to where the houses is, there ain't no plants or nothing.
Yep. Grass all green and shit, man.
Yeah, man. Lakes.
Right. Rivers, they got their own little ponds in the back. I seen it like a couple weeks ago, man. And I'm riding, I'm looking at it, I'm like, well, god damn, man. I'm saying these motherfuckers living good, man.
Yeah.
Hey.
No trash on the ground. I didn't see not a piece of paper on the ground, man.
Yeah, man.
Not a piece of paper, man.
It's lakes and ponds in Gary. Ain't no houses built around the motherfuckers. It's just trees around them, man. Oh. Esau, when he got a lake, he built houses around it. He put a little deck. They got boats and shit.
A little bench.
And lakes in nigga neighborhoods, they don't put no houses around the shit. They don't want us doing the shit they doing, man.
It's funny because I had to do SWAT, basically community service in Chicago. And what they had is going to the Forest Reserve areas out in these crackers neighborhood, and the lakes out there, that's what they building up. And they got the niggas taking care of that shit. You gotta clean it, the Forest Reserve. They got a horse trail. They had us taking the bags of shit, and the bags is plastic bags. And it's ripping and everything, leaking everywhere, throwing it in the trucks and shit, throwing it in the garbage truck. Like, they got niggas doing slave labor out there, literally for these crackers, man. And they built a whole project building up these them damn houses at the lake, man. Right there, man, at the rivers and lakes over there. And behind the Forest Reserve. And they got niggas in there next to taking care of that shit for free. No, Salaki, it's not for free. You gotta pay to do SWAT. You gotta pay to do community service. And then you go clean up for these motherfuckers. Yep,
that's true, man, because the people that come up to my job, man, hey, they make them do like six, especially the motherfuckers in Valparaiso, Porter County, they make it mandatory that they gotta do 6 hours a week, and they make them pay, man. I hear it all the time, man. They get Jake out there in Valparaiso, it would be nothing but niggas coming there for community service. All the fucking time, man.
So don't drink and drive, lesson learned.
Yep. And that's usually what it be, bro. That's the spirit. Or it either
it's
be
all
weed,
DUI.
Either be weed, yeah. Or drinking and driving all the time. Never be nothing else. Go ahead.
Okay, I keep going. This is Ezekiel 35:6. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord Yahweh, I will prepare thee unto blood,
yep.
And blood shall pursue thee, since thou hast not hated blood. Even blood shall pursue thee.
Right, and that's what I was saying before them dudes came up here, we were just going into Esau just be oppressing and fucking up shit, man. He never gets enough, man. You think this man would be tattled going to war, man. That's all he dreams and thinks about, man, is war. He loves it, man. The son of perdition, man. He loves war, man. He got that gun, man, that blessing. And he think nothing can come against that gun, man. He even got the damn lasers in the satellites to fight against the Lord, man. The sword that the Lord gave him. So you think the Lord don't got a better sword than you, man?
So the axe boasted itself against him that he was there with.
Yep.
So that's the sword. Esau being the sword in the Lord's hand, turning towards the Lord, said, I'm going to cut you.
I'm right.
You holding the sword and shit. You cut and killing motherfuckers, and the sword turning you, and I'm finna cut you next. What type of shit is that, man? You gotta be wielded, don't you?
What is that? It's Psalms 11:7, deliver me from him which is thou sword, man.
Somebody
get that real quick. Psalms 11:7, I think, man.
17.
Yeah, 17.
Yeah, hey, that's like if I built a computer, right? And I know that computer inside out. And I built one, I sold it, and then I make me another one. That's like this dude meet me on the internet and trying to override my system and take over my computer, man. When I made the computer that you got,
iRobot. It's basically Esau's iRobot, man. Created, and now he's turning against the one that created him, man. As if the Lord, the one that created him left a message, so he can take him down, man. Right, I'm gonna watch iRobot, man.
Yeah, me too, man.
This is Ecclesiastes.
I'm gonna try to get that breakdown for the longest.
Chapter 6, verse 10. That which hath been is named already, and it is known that it is man. Neither may he contend with him that is mightier than he.
That's right. Yeah. You got that? Who got that in song? 17 and
11?
17
and
13.
It's
17 and 13. Come on. This is Psalm 17 and 13. Arise, O Lord, disappoint him, cast him down, deliver my soul from the wicked. Which is thy sword?
Yeah, that's the point, man. He's the sword of the Lord, man. All right? Go ahead.
No, that's it.
take down the Lord with the sword that he gave you, man. Right? He made you, and he made you the sword.
Right, you the sword in his hand.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Go ahead. This is Isaiah 10:15. Shall the axe boasted? I'm gonna start up some. This is Isaiah 10. Yeah, that's why I clicked on it. 10:12. This is Isaiah 10:12. Wherefore it shall come to pass that when the Lord has performed his whole work upon Mount Zion and on Jerusalem, I will punish the fruit of the stout heart of the king of Assyria and the glory of his high looks. For he said, by the strength of my hand, I have done it, and by my wisdom, for I am prudent, and I have removed the bounds of the people, and have robbed their treasures.
Right. He think he done that by himself, man.
That's right.
That's the spirit of the so-called white. He think he done that shit by himself, man.
Yeah. That's why Obadiah says, pride of thy heart have deceived.
Right.
Right.
The
Babylon has been a golden cup in the Lord's hand. The Lord did all this. The Lord used you to deceive these heathens, to use your petrodollar. The Lord used you and gave you the power to drop missiles, or to have the power of those miracles, cause fire to come down from heaven to scare these nations. The Lord did this, man. And my hand hath found, and have robbed their treasures. I have put down in habits like a valiant man. And my hand has found as a nest the riches of the people. And as one gathered eggs that are left, have I gathered all the earth. And there was none that moved the wing or opened the mouth or peeped. All right, shall the axe boast itself against him that heweth therewith? Or shall the saw magnify itself against him that shaketh it? As if the rod should shake itself against him that lift it up. Or as if the staff should lift up itself as if it were no wood. So basically, so you a piece of wood in the hands of the Lord that the Lord used to smack us around with, man. And now you think that you did it on your own. So now what? The Lord gonna break that piece of wood, man. If you got a fucking malfunctioning ass computer, like the brother said, you're gonna scrap it, man.
Yep.
You're gonna fucking scrap it.
Yep.
It's like they say, it's cheaper to buy a new one, man, than repair the motherfucker.
Yeah, that's right.
I got a piece of it. I get it. This is Proverbs 21:1. It says, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, as the rivers of water. He turneth it whatsoever he will.
Yep, right. That's plain, man.
Right. See my man.
Yep.
Therefore shall the Lord of hosts, send among his fat ones leanness. And under his glory, he shall kindle a burn like the burning of fire. Hey, so you're going to see this economy fall. You're going to see the uprising of the peoples here. You're going to see these streets lit on fire. And then you're going to see that nuclear destruction, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And the light of Israel shall be for fire, and his Holy One for a flame. All right, it's starting now, because we speak this word, you are wood to us, man. All right, so all this shit is going to happen. Not shit, but all these prophecies are going to come to pass, man. The shit will hit the fan. And it's the start of it is the fact that we're raising upon our feet. And that's why Esau and these heathens are trembling, man. All right, because we're waking up, man. We've been at a fire, man.
That's right.
And it shall burn and devour his thorns and his briars in one day, and shall consume the glory of his forest and of his fruitful field, both soul and body. And they shall be as when the standard bearer fainted, man. So the morale of America is going to fall, man. It's starting with the Israelites waking up. All right? And then it's going to end with the Israelites putting you fucking heathens in chains. After that nuclear destruction, man.
And the brother said, the brother said, you know, when you speak these words, you're like wood to these words. But scripture saying, and John says, what else? I should put a word in your mouth, that no man should gainsay or nor resist. Now, what wood gets up from the fire and say, you know, I'm gonna just leave. I don't want you to devour it.
You like the wood on fire,
yeah.
And the piece of the wood jump up and be like, no, nigga.
So once you come in with your bullshit,
do the stop, drop, and roll.
Right.
So when you come with your bullshit get gonna trample down, man.
Yeah, man.
I mean, you can't gainsay against it. Can't say, no, America got this many years.
Right.
Because this. No, man. Not according to the Bible. Not according to the Lord.
Right.
Yeah, man.
Like Romans 3 say, man, just because you don't believe, don't make it not gonna happen, man. It's gonna happen, man. All right, and the devil do believe but tremble, man. You're in denial. You know he's gonna happen. That's why you're scrambling to come up with all these bugged out doctrines. And ultimately, that's why you're gonna come make that move and try to take us down. Because if we're wrong, why you wanna come kill us?
Yeah.
Because you hate us for the blessing that you know is true, man.
Yeah, and he's up in his propaganda. He's making, he's saying, he's got a whole homegrown terror bill that he's working on, crafting. You know what I'm saying? He's trying so hard to put us in the shit, the ISIS and all that bullshit, man. Trying to put us in that group, man. He got us in that group already through Project Megiddo, but now he's trying to find a reason to make us terrorists. You know? And you know what? And you know, and stupid niggas like General Yohana giving them a reason to, man.
That's right.
You know?
Perfect.
Hey, but you know what? Go ahead and do it, because we want you to do it. You know why? Because the scriptures say when the enemy come in like a flood, the Lord's going to lift up a standard against them, man. So we want you to make the man make the move, nigga.
Press the goddamn button. Press the goddamn
button. The button right there, man. It's not like you got to drive 3 hours to push the button. The button right there, man.
Kick it off.
You know, you ain't got to do nothing out of the way to push it.
Right.
Ah, push it. Push it real good. Make sure it goes all the way down. Hey, man, you got something else, man?
Yeah, what's awesome?
This
go ahead,
is Job 34:33. Should it be according to thy mind? It will recompense it. It's like it. He will recompense it. Whether thou refuse or whether thou choose. And not, it's like it. And not I therefore speak what thou knowest. So therefore, no matter whatever you feel, whatever you think, the Lord is still gonna happen, man. Whether you refuse it, it's still gonna happen. It's not gonna stop, man. Judgment is coming to this place, man.
That's right.
Right. Like the brother said, man, if we're wrong, just, you know, then why you got to fear us, man? Just like I don't know who said it in Acts, but he said if these men
Gamaliel.
He said what? He said if these if this work not be of God, it's don't come to naught. You know,
Acts 5.
Yeah. Somebody get it. I don't want to put you here. Yeah.
And this is Nahum 1:2. The Most High is jealous, and the Lord revenge it. The Lord revenge it, and is furious. The Lord will take vengeance on his adversaries, and he reserveth wrath for his enemies. The Lord is slow to anger and great in power, and will not at all acquit the wicked.
Right, because they ask, this must they get judged, man, for the shit they've done to Israel, for the shit they've done to this earth that he created and set up for his anointed, man. It's a must that they be judged, man. It says Ecclesiastics that marvel not when the law is not being fulfilled righteously, man, because they set up, the wicked is set up, man. So they judging us in righteousness. Hey, man, the scripture just said it is the Lord found in righteousness to recompense those who have been recompensed, man. They ass gonna get judged, man. And that time is coming. It is nigh at hand, man. You know?
What's up?
Go ahead, Reed.
This is Isaiah 13:6. How ye, for the day of Yahweh is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty.
Yep, it's gonna come as a destruction. Go ahead.
Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt, and they shall be afraid. Pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them.
Yep, pangs and sorrows, man. You know? it's coming. Hey, the white man, pangs and sorrows are taking hold of him because the children of Israel are waking up, man.
Cause he know what he did, man.
And he know his time is at an end.
Yeah,
man.
And you better believe he ain't sleeping right, man.
No.
Because what happened when they was finna crucify you, how was shot? His wife came to him and said, "Don't touch this runner. Because I was troubled this night, I couldn't sleep."
Yep. Yep. So hey, you know, hey, you better believe, he got all these pills out for erectile dysfunction. He can't even pop his woman right, man. He's so scared. Can't even get a hard on, man. He's scared, man. Go ahead.
They shall be so lucky. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth.
Yeah, go ahead.
They shall be amazed one at another. Their faces shall be as flames. Behold, the day of Yahweh Asmi Arashah cometh quick, cruel both with wrath, fierce anger.
Hey, they coming what? Quick? Quick. It's coming, man. Hey, the time is speeding up, man. The day is fastly approaching, man. Right. Then it said what after that? Cruel. Then it said cruel. Go ahead.
Cruel both with wrath, fierce anger, to lay the land desolate and shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it.
Yeah, and the latest land flat, man. Quick, cruel. Yeah, man. Hey, the Lord is coming, the latest land flat, man.
And he said they shall look at one another and be astounded.
Why?
Yeah, because everything that they've ever done in their past life is going to be shown to them. As they are watching Yahweh Shai coming down in the cherubim with the cherubim, man, they're gonna be looking at one another like, damn, we them people.
No, hey, well, as soon as they see the Lord look like us, man, they're gonna be having heart attacks and shit. Hey, man, they gonna be having strokes. Hey, motherfuckers gonna be trying to kill themselves. You know? Hey, they had just been called one of us a nigger the other day. I hate the black people. I hate those niggers. And then when the Lord come back down looking like us, you better believe they're gonna be scared, man.
That's right.
They're gonna be messed up, man.
I got a piece of
it, bro. Go ahead, brother. Read what you got.
But upon, this is Obadiah 1:17. But upon Mount Zion should be deliverance.
Uh-huh.
And there shall be holiness in the house of Jacob. Should possess their possessions.
Yeah, man. Hey, we're gonna get everything that's been denied of us, man. Been denied for far too long. Now go ahead.
This is Jeremiah 50:40. As Yahweh overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah and the neighbor cities thereof, saith the Lord, so shall no man abide there, neither shall any son of man dwell therein. Behold, a people shall come from the north and a great nation, and many kings shall be raised up from the coast of the earth.
Yeah, that happened when Esau came into power, man.
They shall hold the bow of the land. They are cruel and will not show mercy.
Yeah, they haven't shown mercy. That's why we waiting on Yahweh Shah to deliver us, man. Huh. They're not capable of showing mercy.
Their voice shall roar like the sea. And they shall ride upon horses, everyone put in array like a man to the battle against thee. O daughter of Babylon, the king of Babylon hath heard the report of them, and his hands wax feeble.
Salakia, them coming out the north is talking about the Russian army. All right, that's the Russian army and his the people that he's been a guard to. And essentially all these heat is gonna point the bow at America, man. That battle of Jehoshaphat is being set up right now, man. You're gonna have troops up, you're gonna have this great war with them, Jehoshaphat, and you're gonna have even these heathen troops come on this land, man. America won't be that virgin no more.
That's right.
All
right,
and it's gonna all end with everybody that bent the bow, pointing them at America and shooting them nukes, man.
Yeah.
All right, from that land to the north and all the nations, man, all the kings are gonna rise against this place. Hey. All the kings are arising, man, against this place already.
Yeah, hey, Kim Jong-un said he's prepared for nuclear war, man. He said he's
those American bastards.
Yeah, against those American bastards, man. You know? So he armed and ready, man.
Hard on this. Fuck, one piece of land.
Yeah, man, go ahead.
Angles took hold of him and pains as of a woman and travail.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, he shall come up like a lion from the torrent of Jordan unto the habitation of the throne. But I will make them suddenly run the throne. But I will make them suddenly run away from her. And who is a chosen man that I may appoint over her?
Hey, these nations gonna forsake America, man.
For who is like me? And who will appoint me them felt like it. And who will appoint me the time? And who is that shepherd that was standing before me?